Hi guys, I'm just uploading another video because I actually just filled out a few, job applications and things like that, so wish me luck. I also went on a random search on adoption.com. If you go on there and then you go and click, you have to scroll down to the right side of the page. It's like the second last on the right side of the page. You can go on to adoption registry, and it's for New York. So anybody that lives in New York or wherever you live at, I'm pretty sure that for different cities, it checks up on your IP address and where you are located. So where you're searching from, and then puts in that information. But they do have a registry online, adoption.com, and you go on there and you do a random search of, you know, the basic information that you know, like your birth date. Like, the best thing that I have tried is you put in just your birth date, not the entire date, just like 1985, just that. And then you go to either female or male, and then you put in the state that you were born in. Now it will search for anyone. Like, it has a lot of several different other inquiries, you know, like if you're searching for more detailed search, but I would just go with that for right now. You can search more detailed at first to see if you find anything, but some people, you never know. Some people might not even know the information that you do, you know, concerning your adoption. Like, some people might just know the state. Some people might just know the city. Some people might just know the date and not the actual, like, birth date and everything. Not the entire birth date, just the last four of your birth date. Now, the birth year, excuse me, I don't know why my mind is kind of lost right now, but I just, because there's nothing that comes up except for just my inquiry, like my registry information. That's the only thing that comes up under my exact information that I, the search that I put into of exactly everything. So anyways, I went on this website and put in, like I do several times, and put in the, you know, general information, my birth year, female, and the birth state, and that was all that I basically put in there. So it brought up several different options. None of them actually connected, like none of them really had any information. I did send a message. You know, they didn't really have much information on there to even like give them a call or anything. But 9 times out of 10, somebody has put their contact information and not just an email. So they will put their phone number on there and their full name and things like that. So this one woman, her name was Melissa something, and she put her entire name, her first, middle, and last name. Now, the last name did kind of seem weird to me because it did kind of seem maybe Spanish, but I called her anyways. The number was disconnected, so I'm pretty sure that she had, you know, put in this information a long time ago. So I searched in White Pages her full name and the general area that she was in the last time that she had applied on this adoption registry. Now, I pulled up her phone number. She is actually married. So she is actually married now, and I called the number, and her husband answered, and he was very questionative. Like, he was very suspicious. He was like, what company are you calling from? I was like, hi, may I speak to Melissa? And he's like, she's not here right now. Who is calling? And I said, my name's Holly. And then he's like, what are you calling about? And I said, I'm calling because I see she put some information down on adoption.com and she's searching for someone. So I just, maybe that someone that she's searching for. And then he's like, what company are you calling from? I said, I'm not calling from a company. This, I'm calling from my cell phone at home. And he's like, well, where are you located? And I said, you know, New York, Buffalo, New York. And he was like, well, what is this whole thing? And I explained to him, you know, my situation. I explained to him, like, the information that I found, what she had filled out. He said, well, she's my wife, and I never heard of her ever saying that she filled out information or anything. I said, well, this does look like it was a long time ago, so maybe it was before she met you. I was like, but, like, if you go on adoption.com, you can look up her information and the information that she put down. And I said her first, middle, and last name. He said, well, that's her maiden name, but, you know, I'm her husband and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay, well, could you have her call me or, you know? And he's like, well, yeah, I'll have her call you, but this isn't, like, for a sales pitch or, and I'm like, no, I'm not trying to sell anything. I'm just trying to see if I'm her family. And he was like, okay, well, you know, because if you can't say the last name, then you're not family. And I was like, just because I can't say the last name, I'm like, well, I was adopted, hon. I was adopted when I was born. I was adopted twice. So just because I can't say a last name doesn't mean that I'm not family. It just means that I'm lost family. And really? But anyway, so I think it's Spanish, and he was basically saying that it is Latin. So I don't think that, unless her mother was actually white and she married a Hispanic, you know, like after me, you know, that's very possible. He said that she lives, that her mother lives down in Mexico or something like that. And I'm like, oh, if she's Spanish, then she's not my mom either. But it could be, you know, you never know. I mean, hopefully she'll give me a call back and let me know details. But if she doesn't give me a call back, then he either just didn't give a crap and just was like, fuck you, bitch. You know, my wife isn't looking for anything, because he was like, I just don't trust anybody. And I was like, I fully understand, you know, you're trying to protect your wife, you know, that's understandable. But at the same time, if your wife is actually looking for somebody and someone does call, you know, and finds her information and finds her number and does call to try and reconnect with her, you know, you should allow that to happen, you know, because she's obviously wants that. So, I mean, it could be like, it could be that, this could be the situation, which I doubt it, but you never know. I was like, you know, when my birth mother had me, she could have been with another person. And we could have different fathers, Melissa and I. So she could very well be half Spanish, you know, like on her father's side. Like, you never know. Like, if her mother's white, then, and she has the same ethnic background, we could very well be related. But she did have January 1985, and I was born in August. So, I mean, it's technicalities and things like that, but she might not have the right information or whatever. But hopefully, you know, she'll at least get back to me and let me know, you know, ask questions. You know, she can ask me anything that she wants. Hopefully she will be my sister, but I don't know, it's like a 50-50 chance, and obviously, like, I can't keep my hopes up, because I really just don't believe that really is, like, it could not be her. So I'm not gonna keep my hopes up anymore, because I'm tired of getting them shot down. So anyways, just wanted to let you guys know what was going on, and hopefully, you know, the best comes out of it, you know, for her, you know, to even let her know that, you know, people are actually searching. So hopefully that'll work out. But if it doesn't, then I'm going to just keep it moving. Like, I just got to keep looking, keep searching. for what I know how to do. But, oh well. So, I hope this to you guys was helpful and stuff like that. Like, I know it's nerve-wracking to contact a person, you know, even if they have, if you have a phone number of theirs. It's very nerve-wracking. Like, I'm very nervous when I call. I have made a few calls, but it is very nerve-wracking. I'm not going to lie to you. But you have to figure this in your mind. If you don't call, that one person that you didn't call could possibly be your parents, could possibly be your child, could possibly be the one that you're looking for. You know, so you have to take the risk, because if you don't take a risk, you're never going to know. Just like if you don't ask a question, you're never going to know. So if you don't ask for help, you're never going to get any help. You're never going to get anything. You have to take the risk. You have to jump, because once in a while, you might find what you're looking for. You never know. So that's just a little bit of inspiration to you all. You know, like, I'm sorry, but I don't even think. I don't hesitate. I just call. If I find a number, I just don't even care. I just call immediately. And I've made a few calls, and I've gotten shut down. I've gotten cursed out. I've gotten, you know, oh, you're just a child looking for money from your mommy and daddy. You know, I've had it all. But you know what? That's just retarded-ass people that want to act ignorant. So they don't know the situation that we go through. So all you do with that is you just hang up. Because honestly, you're on a phone. It's not like you're face-to-face. It's not like, you know, you're speaking on Skype. They can't see you. You can't see them. You know what I'm saying? So it's just you both talking. So honestly, take that jump. If you have a phone number and you're just sitting there and staring at the phone number like, oh, this might not be this person. What if it is this person? What if they don't accept me? What if blah, 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 blah? Stop thinking. Stop thinking about the what ifs. Because the one what if that you really need to think about is, what if that's them? That's what you need to think about. All right, guys, I'm out. I love you all, and I hope the best for your searches. I hope that you find the people that you're looking for, and I hope that it's an amazing reunion. I love you. Mwah.